Once upon a time, in a faraway land, there lived a man so exceptional that the divine hosts of heaven and hell were forced to take note. A man dangerous enough to bring Satan to his knees, but selfless enough to make God himself raise an eyebrow. How did this come to pass? Well, it all began at a very special birthday party for a very special young lady.
Surprise!
What is all this?
It's your birthday, Kinsey.
So?
You've never been to a birthday party?
No.
What, like not even growing up?
I went to the School of the Americas since kindergarten. We didn't really do birthday parties.
But you celebrated Christmas.
I don't have to explain myself to you.
Oh, Kinsey, this is going to be so much fun. Xinjai made a cake. Jane Austen is here. We'll play some games.
What sort of games? So you celebrate birthdays by trafficking with spirits?
It's spooky and fun.
It's a bunch of letters.
It's tradition! Every slumber party has to involve a spirit board.
Slumber party.
How's it work?
We ask it a question, and the spirit of the board will reveal the answer.
How?
Yeah, someone pushes the pointy thing to wherever they want.
Wait, can we go back to you and your slumber parties?
No time. All right, everyone put their hands on the cursor.
Cursor? I feel the magic already.
All right. Will the president slash god emperor for life ever choose a partner to reign alongside them?
No.
Ooh, someone's getting married.
Shut up, Matt.
Who will tame the president's wild heart?
What are you cunts trying to spell?
I'm not moving it.
That's the spirit, Kinsey.
I'm serious.
I'm not moving it either.
Neither am I.
Jezebel? Who the fuck...
Is that not normal?
Where'd you get the board?
I was going through Zinyak's artifact collection and found it there.
Who did it belong to?
Aleister Crowley?
Christ. Guys, I think it's laughing at us.
Fuck this. I think you're a smart enough piece of wood to see where this is going. Now, you ready to cooperate? That's more like it.
You think we can trust it?
It's not like we got a lot of options.
So what's the plan? We mount up and go in after the boss?
No, I do. No sense in what's left of humanity walking right into a death trap. Someone's gotta live to tell the story.
That's a stupid plan, Johnny.
I'm leaving you in charge.
Hell of a plan, Johnny!
Are you serious?
I'm coming too.
Are you kidding me?
How do you plan to come back?
Yeah, I try not to sweat the details.
You need someone with you that does.
No.
It's my birthday.
Fine. All right, then. You know where my friend is?
True to its word, the spirit board opened up another portal and sent Johnny and Kinsey screaming into hell.
Ultor's behind this, I know it.
Ultor and the Saints haven't been enemies in years. You really think he's responsible?
You don't know him like I do. The boss put him through a window for a reason.
The reason was the boss was kind of fucking crazy back then.
That's a fair point.
You know how much easier this would be if we just found a car?
You know how much easier this would be if you just gave me a second? Alright, now how are we gonna find the Ultor building?
Biggest building down here, giant Ultor sign on it. I don't think this is a problem.
I'll buy that. Keep it coming.
Look at us. Kinsey Kensington and Johnny Gat driving together on a portly adventure.
Are you always this excited?
Generally, I'm innocent.
I get it. This is hell. Not as bad as I thought.
It kind of reminds me of Steelport. Got the attention of the demons. How do we want to handle this?
We handle it by killing demons. Reminds me of that one time I killed a lot of people.
So, what's the plan?
Oh, yeah. I'm gonna shoot him in the face unless he gives us the boss back.
What if Dean doesn't have the boss?
I'll probably still shoot him in the face.
Welcome to hell.
Shouldn't you have a receptionist?
Such is the plight of eternal damnation. I have a feeling you didn't come here to catch up. Let's talk in my office.
Not even death could stop the enterprising Vogel, who wasted no time in setting up an altar branch in the bowels of hell. Dane was eager to fill Johnny in on the ever-shifting politics of land rights in the underworld. But real estate mattered little to Johnny, who only cared where his friend was.
Where'd you put the president?
I've been trying to explain that I didn't take them.
Bullshit. You expect me to believe you just happen to be the first thing we see in hell?
Maybe it's just me, but your thank you sounds more like an accusation.
That's probably because he plans to kill you.
Okay. I get the trust issues. Can I show you something?
The pieces all came together. The president had caused more chaos and destruction than any other in human history. It was only natural that Satan would want them to marry his daughter. They needed a plan, and Johnny had one.
I'm gonna shoot the devil in the face.
I think you might be skipping some details.
No, I said in the face.
I like the commitment, but you gotta find a way to get close enough to him in the first place.
When's the wedding? I'll just show up
and... And then you'll shoot him in the face. Sorry, but it's a little more complicated than that. These things are tied to the soul. You won't be able to enter without one.
So how do we get one?
You get his attention. I know some places that are of particular value to the father of the bride. You hit those, you'll get your shot.
Wait, why would Satan give out an invitation for destroying his stuff?
Oh, he won't, but it should piss him off enough to get him to attack Johnny personally. Either the devil kills Gat and Ultor gets the construction contracts to rebuild what was destroyed, or Johnny kills Satan and I'll have to pay less taxes. It's pretty win-win.
That's why you're helping us? To make more money in hell?
Hell's what you make of it, sweetie.
Works for me. What you got?
All right.
Satan had entrusted the day-to-day running of hell to 5 archdukes, and Dane knew how to find them all. But beyond that, not everyone in hell was content to go along with Satan's status quo. There were others who shared Dane's ambition for power, and the Ultor mogul knew that the key to unseating Satan lay in gaining their aid. But before Johnny set out to wage war against the Prince of Darkness, Dane had one final gift. An artifact that he had spent fortunes on. Lucifer's cracked halo. This holy relic granted Johnny the majestic wings of the Morning Star. However, he still needed help in learning how to use them.
You got me out in the sticks, now what?
Would it kill you to show a little excitement? You're about to experience angelic flight, for Christ's sake.
Dane.
Someone needs a nap. Just collect some soul clusters and power up the halo. You'll be flying around in no time. Should have just enough clusters to power up your halo. Start slow, try to jump over to that next island. Also, the longer you charge your wings before jumping, the further you'll go. Hey, you didn't fuck it up. Good job. Now get up that cliff. Don't worry, if something looks too high, just keep on jumping off the wall. Remember to charge your jumps if you want to get up the cliff faster. Now it's time to fly. You heard of crawling before walking? Well, in this case, you need to jump before you can fly. Launch yourself in the air with a jump, and then hold your wings out to glide to that next island. Try again. Here's a tip. You don't need to get a running start to fly, just jump. Then hold your wings out to glide. Let the wings do the work. One
more time. Jump, then hold out your wings. Once you're in the air, just keep those wings out and guide yourself to the next island. Try again. Here's a tip. You don't need to get a running start to fly. Just jump, then hold your wings out to glide. Let the wings do the work.
Got a touchdown. Damn it.
One more time. Jump, then hold out your wings. Once you're in the air, just keep those wings out and guide yourself to the next island. You'll have to dive to reach the next island. Do that by pointing your head down. Don't worry, the rest of your body will follow. I put a shiny flap orb out in front of you. Collect the orb, and your wings will flap to gain speed. Alright, now try flapping those wings on your own. Do a flap on your way to the next island. Woo! The exact opposite of diving is climbing. Climbing will slow you down and eventually cause you to stall. And trust me, stalling sucks. You can flap while gliding to gain additional speed. So the faster you're going, the higher you can fly. Now try to reach the island up there. Time to take the training wheels off for the final lesson. Flying takes stamina. If you run out in midair, you are going to drop like a rock. A stupid, stupid, stamina-less rock. Last island is right under those lava falls. Notice how your stamina drains the longer you glide. Let's get you back to the old tour building. I want to run through all the stuff you can do to hurt Satan.
Sure thing. See you soon.
Here's the deal. If you want some face time with Satan, you need to get his attention. Now, Satan hates being challenged, so anything you do to undermine his control is good. Fraud, mayhem, shooting demons in the face, anything. You can keep track of Satan's wrath with this handy meter. Get it high enough, and you'll be having drinks with Big Red in no time. I've compiled a list of shit to do, so take a look and do whatever sounds fun. Oh, one more thing. We have some potential allies down here. Trust me. You want to impress them.
I hope there's not something ridiculous like 100 of these to find. Lost count on these things. Note to
everyone's chasing the Stygian dream down here. A way to make hell just a little more tolerable. And when you're surrounded with that amount of desperation, believe me, it's easy to find people who lay it all on the line for next to nothing. Some folks think I had all this handed to me and I take advantage of people, but here's the God's honest truth. In life, opportunities mean fuck all if you do nothing with them. Most of these poor bastards down here whine about their lot in life, but are unwilling to do anything about it. That's not me.
God, this feels good.
Abandon ship! We've been boarded!
Success.
There's a bit of treasure in that chest over there. The weapon you find inside may help with our little imp problem. Summon these imps to serve as my crew. I forgot what a handful they could be. Once aboard, they wouldn't listen to their captain. They ran amok in the bowels of the ship.
Fantastic
work!
Not another one of these.
Fuck off. Get off, you piece of shit.
Who left now?
Drop the pirate.
What pirate voice would that be?
Wow.
Zinyak's destruction of Earth had a profound impact on the afterlife. To heaven, it was a logistical nightmare. Saint Peter's meticulous nature drove purgatory wait times to unbearable levels. Meanwhile, in hell, where souls in pain were used as currency, it created a new era of prosperity for the wicked. Boon resulted in the coffers of hell to be overflowing, which in turn piqued the interest of the most notorious man that sailed the seven seas. Long had Blackbeard been a thorn in Satan's side, robbing tax collectors on a semi-regular basis. But the promise of an immeasurable fortune drove him to be even bolder. An arrangement was reached. Blackbeard would provide information on strategic targets in exchange for a share of the profit. Johnny, who was interested in murder, not money, happily agreed.
I grant ye the ability to summon my crew whenever they're needed. Matey, it's time for your lesson. Let's summon me favorite scurvy-riddled hellion, the Imp. Why don't you start off by summoning an imp to take out those enemies? No, let the imps do the work, matey. Leave your guns and fists out of this. Down the other demon. Eagle biters are vicious. Now let's practice your aim. Take down the demons on the island. Someone into service, am I right? Now get going. There's a whole wide world waiting to be plundered.
I
raided a Centerpol office and found information on where the president is being kept. Evidently, they've been trapped in some sort of soul crystal inside Satan's palace. Breaking in is an impossibility. Your best bet to save them is to continue to try to draw Satan out of his palace.
Harder than that, Satan.
Yeah.
to pick it up.
This is bad timing.
Lights up. William Shakespeare, humanity's greatest playwright.
and hell's most diabolical purveyor of entertainment, looks on as a brave mortal on an Orphean quest enters. The bard's interest is piqued, and he looks to test his visitor's mettle. The masked tragedies were used to enemies cowering as they approached, but soon they realized that they faced a foe with courage and nobility, traits uncommon in the fires of perdition. Incident resolved. The time had come for rising action. Raged on below, and as bullets and blood flew, the bard arched a curious eyebrow. Could this mortal be the exact thing that Shakespeare needed?
Got a touchdown.
The conflict resolved. Shakespeare eagerly awaited meeting the champion that dispatched so many of his men. Undoubtedly, they were here for the bard's aid. And while happy endings were not a thing found in hell, Shakespeare always had a soft spot for comedies.
In the land of the living, William Shakespeare is regarded as one of the most prolific playwrights of all time. However, to the denizens of hell, the bard is seen in a far different light. After selling his soul for fame and adoration, Shakespeare served in hell as Satan's spy master general. In doing his duty, Shakespeare would punish the souls he was investigating by forcing them to perform in grotesque passion plays for Satan's amusement. But in a Twelfth Night-esque twist, Shakespeare found himself living a double life. While he projected an image of cruelty, his heart was as soft as Jezebel's. In secret, he would tutor her on the classics and act out the works of his mortal days. When Satan found out, he cast Shakespeare out of the palace, believing that the poet would be tormented by the populace of hell, far out of Jezebel's sight. But Satan had not counted on the bard's cunning. Embracing his persona of master torturer, Shakespeare and his followers, the tragedies, took root in the entertainment district, biding their time for revenge.
And so Shakespeare called forth the Deus Ex Machina to bestow our protagonist with the arcane power
of Force Storm.
Lights up! The mortal stands in the training grounds, eager to try out his new Force Stomp power on the group of demons in front of them.
No pity for the mortal!
Act 1, Scene 2, in which our protagonist kills more demons. Act 2, in which our protagonist is greeted by foul imps. Our protagonist learns that Force Stomp even works on flying enemies, enabling them to remove a Dark Inciter's shield before shooting them to death with bullets. There is also a mistaken identity, and the day...
The horn on the bus goes beep, 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 beep.
What, if they wanted to torture me, why'd they use the short version of the song?
This is the short version?
Oh, yeah. The wipers on the bus go swish, swish, swish. The hobo on the bus goes heh, heh, heh. My mom had like 80 of them.
The driver on the bus says tickets, please.
Driver on the bus says, tickets, please. Tickets, please. Tickets, please. Driver on the bus says, tickets, please. All day long. The babies on the
you
bus say,
the
wah, wah, wah.
We must end this infernal music! Come, let us return to my castle, so we may plot our next steps in proper surrounds.
Johnny led Vlad back to his castle, which since his incarceration became a haven for frat parties and squatters. But the systematic impaling of trespassers would have to wait. Vlad was a man of his word, and was eager to provide intel that could aid in hobbling Satan's armies.
I bestow upon you the Stygian cold fire. I hate making pacts with criminals, but I will stand with Blackbeard if it means getting my revenge. I brought you to this inferno to teach you about the power I have granted you. Coldfire is an aura, which means you must activate the power and get close to an enemy before they will feel the cold embrace of the Stygian flame. Try it against these demons.
I should have fucked with me.
Well done, my friend. Now here comes a dark inciter. Use your aura, then get close to him to take down him. You've done it. Doesn't it feel good to watch an enemy burn?
What these things can do. This is bad timing. God, this feels good.
Fucking collectibles. Really didn't have a chance. Nice.
We're standing in a parking garage.
I don't like it either, but Centerpool isn't giving us many options.
I can't believe they tried to force us out.
I can't believe you forgot the mimosas.
I think we have bigger problems.
I don't think you realize how much I love mimosas.
I can't help but notice that people are trying to kill you.
Yeah, they're really big on that here.
What did you do?
Is now really a good time? We can wait until we're done shooting people.
Well, I'm great at multitasking.
Remember when we offered you a deal on that airplane and you responded by killing everyone?
Yeah.
It's like that, but worse.
The screams of success.
Viola, thought you should know that Kinsey misses you.
Really? That's so sweet.
Who's Kinsey?
You remember Kinsey. She was that hacker that Matt Miller hated.
Isn't she crazy?
You know, she really grows on you.
Let's get you two back to Dane.
Hooray!
After being reunited in hell, Kiki and Viola wasted no time in doing what they do best: facilitate the running of businesses. However, the De Winter sisters' success did not sit well with other would-be power players in hell. The sisters' operations all came under attack at once, forcing them on the run. Soon, the twins found themselves on the receiving end of an offer they couldn't refuse. After all, It was better to own 1/5 of something than to be dead.
You helped us. Now let us help you.
Here's a little something made popular by another group of sisters, the Gorgons. Dane's letting us use his old tour training room to test out your stone blast power. So go ahead and blast these demons to turn them to stone.
Your suffering is legendary.
Winning isn't important. Body count.
Nice! Stone blast is especially useful on flying demons like this one. Alright, now let's see you drop a few more. Blast will also take down the shield of a Dark Insider, leaving it vulnerable to gunfire. Take this Dark Insider out. I think you've got the gist of it. All right, let's go.
Enough's enough, Gat!
I gotta get this someplace safe. One more for the collection.
Check out the vending machine near the Ultor building. Is it a special vending machine? No. Have you bought stuff from a store already? Probably. But I would be remiss as your guide if I didn't show you the basics.
Better and better. Now this brings me back.
Go!
Too easy.
Thank you.
The Forge is prime real estate in Hell. This smoggy shithole is located over the richest mineral veins in the afterlife. You want to hurt Hell's infrastructure? Here's where you do it. My lawyer, Legal Lee, figured out a way to get some gold-level clients a fast track out of Hell. The more abuse you put these guys through, the more years we can shave off. Lee suggested running clients through the designated intersections to boost their punishment. Oh, and dive in front of those vehicles on fire for bonus points. I mean, let's face it, the more they hurt, the sooner we can get these wretched bastards out of here.
While his wife Laura was admitted into heaven, the Heavenly Father was less forgiving of poor Tobias, whose shirtless antics as a crazed drug dealer firm. However, ever the optimist, Tobias tried to look on the bright side of being transformed into a husk. After all, while the removal of his signature dreadlocks was a disappointment, he was finally free from having to wear pants ever again. But while Perpetual Commando appealed to Tobias, he still yearned for Laura and her delightful snickerdoodles. Touched by his story and terrified by his demeanor, Legal Lee worked with renewed purpose to unite the two lovers.
Thank you.
buddy. Let's take this opportunity to stretch those wings. I've set up a rudimentary flight path through the city. All you need to do is hit the checkpoints in the order they appear. Now, because I'm a swell guy, I put some orbs out there to help you. The white ones will recharge your wings. The green ones will give you more stamina. Let's go.
Gotta pick it up. Yeah! Got a touchdown. This feels good.
One of these things, and let's be honest, you have four to choose from. It's not rocket science. You'll be imbued with the new arcane element for that power. Sounds too good to be true? Well, it kinda is. Once you steal the power from the altar, a bunch of guardians will appear and try to kill you. But if you use your new power to clear them out, it's yours to keep.
Use the Shadow Blast to trap your enemies in a tenebrous cloud. The darkness will slow them down while they choke to death.
God, this feels good. Running out of juice. Fucking collectible. One more. See what these things can do. Need the rest of wings. This is what I'm talking about. Well, looky here. This feels good. these things can do.
Got a touchdown.
Running out of juice. I will fucking end you. God, this feels good. One more.
Got a touchdown.
Scared of you?
This is bad timing. This is what I'm talking about.
verify more of these things.
The collection. These things can do.
I'm going to prove.
I know your best friend is trapped in hell, and that sucks and all, but I really could use your expertise over here in the Forge.
Nice. See what these things can do. Fucking collectibles. Where's my statue? I kill more guys than this chump. Running out of juice. I got it.
gotta get this someplace safe. Gotta pick it up.
Okay, I have a thought on how we can get the attention of Satan, and I really think you're gonna like this one. Blow the shit out of everything, and I mean everything! Demons, cars, fences are real popular. Just tear this place apart!
Play.
these things can do.
All right, it's salvation time. Satan's using his magic to send souls skyward and downward into oblivion. That's where you come in. Catch the falling souls before they hit ground and use an arcane blast to free the souls rising upward. Of course, once you do that, you'll still have to catch them before they drift off to their death. Speed is key here. You'll get a bonus for every soul you can save before touching down. Now let's go save some clients. I mean souls. Poor souls that need help.
Gotta pick it up. This is bad timing. This feels good.
Running out of juice.
Now's the time to collect as many souls as I can.
Got a touchdown.
God, this feels good.
This is bad timing.
Sorry.
looky here. Let's see what these things can do.
Just entered one of four soul extraction facilities. This is where souls enter hell to have their sins removed and then thrown to the streets to wander for eternity. Now make no mistake, this isn't Satan being magnanimous. Sins are the currency in hell. That means these places are the cornerstone of his income. There's three sections of the facility, and to fully take it over, you need to capture all three. But be careful. Satan's goons are going to be looking to reclaim any section you're not guarding. We pull this off, you'll hurt Satan and Ultor makes money. It's win-win.
Turn down!
body.
I killed. Running out of juice. Not again.
Jezebel's wedding after all the damage you've done? I'm telling you, the devil is about to react in a big way, and when he does, we need to be ready.
Satan didn't have much time to react to the war Gat was waging, because at home, Jezebel was waging a war of her own.
I don't love them!
You think I care?
If you started acting like a father, you would.
I'm looking after your best interest.
You don't care about my happiness! This is about you! If you just stop telling—
You will marry that saint, and I won't hear another word!
I won't do it!
You think because you're my daughter, you think that you're above it all. But schemes are currently in motion. Your choice, be a wife or be a thrall. They say the devil's in the details. eyes, and I have some more for you. Celestial light doesn't shine a ray here. Happy endings are through. You belong to me. I'm giving you away. Your blood will not save you. My hand will be cruel if you disobey. Belong to me.
Never. I'm sick of perdition, so tired of tradition, but now my time has come to go break away, to live for today, to stand out beneath the sun. I know there has to be torturous pain, some place that's far from here, and not awash with fear. Oh God, I can't wait to cast off this hate. I want to find love. There's a big wide world for me to explore, so many things that I don't know. Like, would I like ice cream? How do I feel about cats? And is Nightblade my new favorite show? But until that time, I'm stuck in this hell, a relentless tempest of rage. Surrounded by guards, betrothed by my father, trapped inside this gilded cage.
It's not working, Kinsey.
You don't know that, Johnny.
I'm tearing this place apart, but Satan doesn't even seem to...
We didn't come this far to fail.
You think I'm giving up?
We have one less place to go.
What if it doesn't work?
The bus is counting on us.
You think I don't know? How do I burn down a city that's baptized in fire? How do I kill off an army that's dead? Time's slipping away now, and the best plan we've got is just put one inside Satan's head. If roles were reversed, God, I know they'd save me. But all my solutions involve murder sprees.
You have to stay the course and kill without remorse.
Yeah, that sounds fun, but what has that done? We're still where we stand.
The day isn't over yet. Our sun's not begun to set. No matter how small, the wings of a fly can create hurricanes.
Johnny Gat. Hope. I feel hope. For the first time I've ever in my life. Gat is the name that cuts through my father like a knife. The seed of rebellion, it grows like a weed. And someone so violent is just what I need. There's no turning back now, the die has been cast. This sinner has found her saint, I'll be free at last. The people, the music, it waits up above. I know I'll be happy when I find love. I know I'll be happy when I find
Great work. Ultor is moving into the territory you freed up, and we're already seeing a difference. I can't wait to see what happens when we own it all.